You're fine. Keep on going. No, just start. Talk to me. What's up?
I just don't do well when I'm being recorded. Like, I've been recorded for interviews before, and
it's really tough.
I catch myself saying a lot, and then I get uncomfortable, so I just need a minute to.
Take
I get
time.
Like super uncomfortable when being recorded.
No, and I get it. And we didn't And again, this is something we have to do a better job of, but we didn't prep you at all for this. So I am super overwhelmingly excited that you've even agreed to do it. Because again, it's nerve-wracking being on camera. But I promise we're only going to take the pieces we definitely need, and we won't take the whole thing. And you look great, and I'll even show you how you look so you can know that you look amazing. And yeah, so I don't want you to make a big thing out of it, because you don't have to.
Okay.
So start off when you're ready.
So I started my teaching career as a New York City teaching fellow, which meant that I had some previous teaching experience, but overseas with Peace Corps, which was very informal. So when I started formally teaching here in the United States, I only had about 6 weeks of training before I was put into a classroom. So the program itself, NYCTF, I would recommend it if you are wanting to jumpstart your career, but it's very overwhelming. Very quick amount of training, very basic, and focused on classroom management and not so much on lesson planning and using different teaching strategies, very much just management focused. And then you're in a classroom. You're hired and you're in a classroom. So in addition to that, starting in a school that had a bit of a challenging group of students who had all had, all of my students my first year had had living environment before, so getting buy-in from them was also it was hard, and I didn't have any resources or background to kind of draw off of.
When you say resources, what do you mean?
Like curriculum that was...
Got it.
curriculum, lesson planning, ideas or strategies to use with certain topics. I didn't have anything. They don't send you with anything.
So you're going in cold turkey.
Yeah, basically. So it was very challenging and overwhelming. And in addition to everything else that you're dealing with as a first year teacher, I didn't even really know how to structure a unit plan. So my first year, I struggled a lot. My team, at the time was three other teachers for my core team, the English teacher, the global teacher, and math teacher, and they were all experienced and very understanding, very supportive, which helped a lot. And I got to spend a lot of time talking to them during our common planning time, bouncing ideas off of them. We were using similar strategies in class so we could figure out what strategies were working with the students and which were not, and how they were using the same strategies that they were encouraging me to use. So getting ideas from each other, knowing how well they were working, teasing out what was successful about those strategies and what was not, was what really helped me kind of start to get on my feet. Just honestly having the support of those teachers. Getting to do intervisitations, getting to see other teachers in the classroom working with my same students. Getting to see other teachers, so not just my team with my group of students, but also doing their visitations of other experienced teachers like the 11th, 12th grade, and 9th grade, getting to see all the different grade teams, all the different levels.
I'm sorry, I think you're going to tell me, but how do you think the intervisitations, seeing your young people, and maybe in even a different environment, how did that impact your own teaching style and some of the classroom things that you were doing?
So it not only gave me different strategies to use with the students in like introducing new content, how to model certain things, such as simple things as like note-taking, how to organize a lab or an activity that might be a little bit more chaotic, seeing how other people were doing it was giving me ideas that I could then carry over to my classroom, and seeing what worked with those students, being able to see like how I was working with the 9th grade, and then maybe seeing a similar strategy being used with the upperclassmen and trying to adjust it to where it would work in my classroom. our school was doing was encouraging using the same strategies with all grade levels, but obviously scaffolding it for each grade level. And that helped to be able to go into different classrooms and see that they were doing very similar things, no matter the content, no matter the grade level, but adjusting it to be specific to the content of the grade level.
And how long did you, you were in Common Playing Time for, what, an hour a day, 2 hours a day?
So as a team, we meet for 1 hour a day, and then we have one prep period. So we at least get 55 minutes to sit down with our team every day, which, and 45 minutes on Wednesdays. Last year, the way that it was organized is we would have specific tasks that we would, or specific topics that we would need to discuss that day. So like, one day would be data, another day would be kid talk, where we're talking about the students that are specifically struggling. Kid talk would be the day that we discuss specific students that are struggling due to maybe a crisis outside of school, and how to best handle that situation. We have schedule and advocacy planning days, so schedule days where we're updating grades, making phone calls home, deciding who's kind of allocating who's going to be calling which students, and it would usually be the students that were in our advocacy, and making sure that we're all on the same page if we were speaking to the parent as to what we wanted the parent to know or focus on, and then looking at student work, so student work protocol, where if we're using the same strategy, we bring in the student work from that activity and be able to suss out what was actually being successful, where the students